what is it in terms of gene activity, in terms of the activity of nerve cells in different parts of the brains that allow these animals to show the kinds of social behavior, such as aggressive behavior or parental care behavior. Cichlids are unusual. They are very colorful fish, and they are colorful because they communicate with their colors. They have very complex social behavior that they use to reproduce, to establish territories, to fight for resources. They also take care of their offspring. There are thousands of species that have evolved in a very short period of time, but they are very different. Even though it's a little simplistic, you can think of it in a way as a mutant. So if you have a genetic mutant, then one gene no longer functions normally. And as a consequence, the animal that has this mutation will, you know, do something different. It will look different or will show a different behavior. In the cichlid fishes, we have a few thousand of those mutants that nature has made for us. Again, this is somewhat simplistic, but it's a good way to think about it. And as a consequence, because there are very few genetic differences between those species, but very big behavioral differences, we can use the diversity of cichlid fishes and the differences in the genetic differences that we can identify to basically establish the relationship between the genes that regulate behavior or affect behavior and the behavior itself. We know that the behavior itself and the environment in which it takes place, the social environment in particular, feedback onto the brain and affect the brain and how the brain functions. And so, you know, depending on the social environment you're in, you will behave differently, your brain will function differently. And as it turns out, these fishes, these cichlid fishes, are very useful, a useful model system for that, because we can manipulate the social environment very easily in the laboratory and then look in the brain what has changed. Are there anatomical changes in terms of the structure of the nervous system? Are there differences in the activity of particular genes? And in fact, we find that a large chunk of the genome, so many of the genes that are encoded by the genome, change depending on their activity, depending on the social environment. We have a better understanding because of research on cichlid fishes of how these kinds of different social systems, different mating systems, like monogamy or non-monogamy, like taking care of your offspring or not taking care of your offspring, how they have evolved, because we have this diversity of species that do different things. Those genes are very much the same that are also important for this kind of behavior in mammals, including our own species most likely.
For more information about the Brain Initiative, visit nsf.gov/brain.